Hi everyone, Darren from DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. With the current effort to slow the spread of the 2019 coronavirus, also known as COVID-19, now more than ever, many businesses are looking at how they can operate by having employees work from home. Accessing company resources, even PBX phone systems, is all possible over the internet using a secure VPN, a virtual private network. We'll start by looking at what a VPN is and the types of VPNs available that can be used to access the company network and resources from another location. The level of security may be a concern as well and will determine your choice of VPN protocol to use, and we'll discuss the advantages or disadvantages that each one offers. Then we'll look at how to choose the most suitable router for the task. So let's start by looking at what a VPN is. A virtual private network, otherwise known as a VPN, provides a secure and low-cost method for computers in different locations to communicate with each other across the internet, much the same as if they were on the same local area network. There's no need for a dedicated link between two sites, such as a cable or maybe a Wi-Fi link, to allow the secure exchange of data. Computers can instead communicate across public networks or a wide area network in a manner that emulates the properties of a point-to-point private link. So a VPN is basically an extension of a private network using links spread across shared or public networks such as the internet. I'll include a link below to a video with a basic explanation of VPNs and how easy it is to create an SSL VPN using the free DrayTek Smart VPN application on an iOS device. The term VPN tunnel is used to describe the connection between your computer and the VPN server, or connection between VPN servers. It's essentially a communication channel, or a tunnel if you like, which protects data being transmitted within it from being accessed by anyone else. An analogy is a road tunnel for cars, where the concrete tunnel itself protects the cars driving through it from the water or earth above from crashing down. As you're probably aware, a lot of businesses choose to adopt virtual private networks to share their resources with employees and partners who aren't based in the office at all times. I'm one of those myself. I'm based up in Brisbane and I have access to shared drives in the Sydney office, and I even have an IP phone connected to the Sydney switchboard so we can transfer calls to and from each other, or I can talk to staff internally at their extensions. If you're in Brisbane, don't forget we can arrange for you to pick some orders up from here, and I'm always available by phone or email if I can ever help out with anything. Organisations have also begun using VPNs to outsource their work, enabling them to lower internal staff costs while maintaining data security. At the moment with coronavirus, it means companies can minimise the possible impact of the virus spreading by having selected staff work from home, or the business can continue operating if it is put under quarantine or if we go to a higher level of restrictions. It's important to emphasise that VPNs need to be secure. Data breaches not only lead to compensation and regulatory fines, but can leave lasting reputational damage. We'll now look at the types of VPN tunnels. There's two main types of VPN tunnels available in DrayTek routers. The first is a LAN-to-LAN VPN tunnel, and the second is a remote dial-in VPN. LAN-to-LAN VPN tunnels are used to connect two whole LANs to each other. For example, a branch office or a home office, or someone working home with multiple devices connected to the head office for sharing resources. Through one VPN tunnel, many users or many devices can be connected to the same network over the internet. The users at the branch office can access servers and printers, for example, as if they were on the head office local network. In this mode, only one VPN connection is created, and all staff at the branch office can access the head office services through it. At the same time, head office staff can access the branch office services. One requirement to be aware of is that the two networks should not have the same subnet, as shown in the example here. Router A, that's the headquarters on the left, is configured as the VPN server and has LAN IP subnets of 192.168.1.0 and 192.168.3.0. While Router B, that's the remote branch office, is configured as the VPN client and has LAN IP subnet of 192.168.2.0, which is different from the Router A subnets. Once connected to the head office network, you'll then be able to access anything the head office network is connected to as well. One example of that given here is if the head office is connected to a cloud server, then once the branch office connects to the head office via VPN, it will also be able to access that cloud server. The second type of VPN is a remote dial-in VPN tunnel, also known as a host-to-gateway or host-to-LAN VPN. Here, a single user uses a VPN client, that's software, running on the computer to set up a VPN tunnel for secure communication with the head office network. The VPN client will use an IP address in the local subnet at the remote network. Note that each remote dial-in VPN tunnel created counts towards the total number of VPN tunnels supported by the router. For example, the Vigor 2862 series routers support a maximum of 32 VPN tunnels, and these can be 32 remote dialing connections or a combination of dialing connections and LAN-to-LAN VPNs. Most VPN clients will work for remote dial-in to a DrayTek router. The most common are the default VPN client built into Windows or DrayTek Smart VPN client, which is available as a free download. We'll now look at the VPN protocols and how VPN tunneling works. This diagram shows a basic representation of how VPN tunneling works. In step one, the data payload is sent from a PC to the destination network. In step two, the sending router appends a tunneling header to the data packet, and this encapsulated payload is then sent across the internet to the destination router in step three. And finally, the tunneling header is removed by the destination router, and the data payload is sent to its final destination in step four. Some tunneling protocols not only encapsulate the data, but can also encrypt it to further protect the confidentiality and integrity of the information. As shown in this diagram, the routers at each end of the VPN tunnel encrypt and decrypt the data as it is sent and received. DrayTek routers include the most common VPN tunneling protocols listed here, with no additional licensing requirements. Down the bottom there, OpenVPN was added from firmware version 3.9.0 in DrayOS routers. Security features for some of those VPN protocols are shown in this table. At the top, we have GRE, or Generic Routing Encapsulation, which is a basic protocol that offers no encryption or peer authentication. We use GRE where IP tunneling without privacy is required. It's simpler and therefore faster. It's also used inside an IPsec VPN tunnel in DrayTek's VPN load balancing feature. I'll include a link to a video below about VPN load balance if you'd like more information. PPTP adds a bit more security, requiring a username and password to authenticate, but it can also be encrypted as well. L2TP, Layer 2 Tunneling Protocol, can offer a higher level of security than PPTP if we combine it with an IPsec policy pre-shared key to authenticate. IPsec is the king of VPN security and is generally the way to go for business networks. It uses a pre-shared key with varying levels of encryption to authenticate. It generally requires a static or fixed IP address at both ends, but this can be worked around using DrayTek's aggressive mode IPsec VPN, which uses peer ID to authenticate the connection. I'll explain a bit more about IPsec in a moment. SSL, or Secure Sockets Layer VPN, uses the same HTTPS protocol used by secure websites. This means as long as the router allows HTTPS traffic through it, an SSL VPN should get through it as well. It's a great one for remote dial-in users using ISP-supplied gateways they have no idea how to configure, or the ISP may even have locked the interface. There's fewer restrictions for the data encrypted through SSL when compared with a traditional VPN. DrayTek Smart VPN client has an SSL option, and it's supported by Windows PCs, Android, and Apple Mac devices. You can even initiate an SSL VPN using just a web browser, but DrayTek Smart VPN client is the preferred way to go. Here's some recommendations for different operating systems. For Windows, we recommend an L2TP over IPsec VPN. Most others go for an IPsec variation, or alternatively, SSL or OpenVPN for remote dial-in users. DrayTek Smart VPN client has options to create both OpenVPN and SSL VPNs. This diagram shows the different stages in setting up an IPsec VPN tunnel. We have the call initiation. Interesting traffic there in step one is just the term for traffic that is to be encrypted over the VPN connection. Handshaking, IKE phase one and IKE phase two in steps two and three, and then tunnel establishment. That's a fairly basic idea of what happens, but understanding the different stages involved will help to troubleshoot IPsec VPN connectivity issues. There's plenty of knowledge base articles and guides and YouTube videos that describe how IPsec works, so check out our knowledge base or the knowledge base at draytek.com, or even just have a Google around. Once you've done one, they're really not that hard. Creating VPN tunnels is quite easy in DrayTek routers. There's two ways to go about it. The first one is the wizard, which you'll find up the top of the left-hand menu in the router's web user interface. There's a VPN client wizard and a VPN server wizard. For the VPN client wizard, you'll be connecting the router to another router, which makes it a LAN-to-LAN VPN. You just select the next blank index from the pull-down menu beside where it says, please choose a LAN-to-LAN profile, and follow your nose from there. The VPN server means you're configuring the router to accept inbound VPN connections from authorized users. That can be done either as a LAN-to-LAN VPN for another router to connect in, or to allow remote dial-in users to connect. Alternatively, you can create VPNs manually by going to the VPN and remote access section in the web user interface. For LAN-to-LAN VPNs, select that option from the menu, then click on the next available index. In this case, they're all blank, so we'd select number one. The settings you need to enter in the index to create the LAN-to-LAN profile are basically entering what sort of VPN you want to use, for example, PPTP or IPsec, where you need to connect to or from, that is whether this router is the VPN server or the client, and deciding what authentication and encryption methods you'd like to use. If you'd like more information about those settings, please check out the knowledge bases on draytek.com.au and draytek.com. To configure remote dial-in accounts is much the same. Go to VPN and Remote Access and select Remote Dial-in User. Note down the bottom here, there's links to download the free DrayTek Smart VPN client. Then select the next available index. So here we're creating a profile that is allowed to VPN into the router from another location. And after enabling it, we need to establish what type of VPN this person is allowed to use. They're all allowed by default. Notice there's an SSL option there down the bottom too. So you can untick any you don't want to be used and then select an authentication method on the right. You might also notice there's an option down on the bottom left there where you can specify a particular LAN subnet you want this user to be able to access. To dial in from a PC, you'll need a VPN client application. Here's the Windows 10 version. You'll see it's basically a case of telling it where to connect to, what type of VPN to use, and how it needs to authenticate. That will obviously need to match the details we entered for this person's profile in the router in the previous slide. And here's DrayTek Smart VPN app. It's available as a free download from draytek.com or draytek.com.au, as well as the App Store and Google Play. Pictured here is what it looks like installed on iOS 9. And this is the PC version. Again, it's just a case of telling it where to connect to, what type of VPN to use, and how it needs to authenticate. If we select IPsec, we see all the security and authentication methods we can use. As I mentioned, there's a lot of application notes in the knowledge base at draytek.com for both LAN-to-LAN and dial-in VPNs. To find them, click on the knowledge base link under support at the top of the page at draytek.com. You should see the VPN category at the top of the right-hand column, otherwise just search for VPN. There's also quite a few videos on our YouTube channel, including a playlist with all of our VPN-related videos in it. Just scroll down the homepage until you see the VPN using DrayTek router playlist. I'll also include a link to it in the description below. We'll now look at how to choose the right router. Two main factors decide which router will best suit your needs, what type of internet connection you have, and how many simultaneous VPNs you require. This table shows the number of supported VPN tunnels in models featuring an ADSL or VDSL2 modem. So these suit people with ADSL or NBN fiber to the node or fiber to the building connections. But they also have gigabit Ethernet WAN ports, so they can also be used for internet connections requiring one of those. Or they can even be connected to 3G or 4G internet using a compatible USB modem. The Vigor 2762 series is a great one for a small branch or a single remote user to create a LAN-to-LAN VPN to the main office. The Vigor 2862 series is the better way to go for a larger office. This table shows the number of supported VPN tunnels in models featuring one or more Ethernet WAN ports, which are suitable for cable internet and NBN fiber to the premises, fiber to the curb, hybrid fiber coaxial, fixed wireless and SkyMaster satellite connections. Or you can plug in a VDSL modem like the Vigor 130 in bridging mode into one of their Ethernet WAN ports. You might do that where you need the features of a router like the Vigor 3910 in the right hand column, but you have a VDSL connection. Most models also feature at least one USB port to connect a compatible 3G or 4G USB modem. The bottom two rows show the number of simultaneous VPNs supported, which will give you an idea of the size of office that they're designed in mind for. And this table shows DrayTek products featuring a built-in LTE modem, which just needs a SIM to connect to 4G. One handy feature in the Vigor LTE 200N and 2620 LTE series is that they can be configured in bridge mode to allow them to be connected into the Ethernet WAN ports of more advanced routers like the Vigor 3910 shown in the previous table. I'll include a link in the description below to a video on that topic explaining how to do it. And speaking of LTE, you might find that some ISPs only assign private IP addresses which aren't suitable for VPNs. This makes it kind of difficult to establish LAN-to-LAN VPN tunnels. DrayTek's VPN Matcher is a solution developed by DrayTek which works around this problem by providing an authentication server known as the DrayTek VPN Matcher server. This feature is currently available on the higher end routers such as the Vigor 2862 and Vigor 2926 series and the Vigor 3910 running the latest firmware. How it works is, first of all, the routers at both ends need to register with the VPN Matcher server. The VPN Matcher server then exchanges external IP addresses and port numbers to both routers that want to communicate. When the client router initiates a connection to the server router, the VPN Matcher server will instruct both routers to open the required ports and allow the VPN to be established. Be aware that VPN Matcher only receives information about IP addresses and port numbers. It has no access to the VPN traffic itself. There's an application note in the DrayTek.com knowledge base with more information about VPN Matcher and how to configure routers to use it. If you go to DrayTek.com, mouse over Solutions at the top of the page, and then click on the VPN Matcher link. That page will provide some background information as well as a link to the application note. VPN Matcher can also be used for dial-in VPNs, otherwise known as a host-to-LAN VPN. There's a config example for that, which you can get to by changing the number at the end of the previous URL from 6124 to 6125, or just search for VPN Matcher on the DrayTek.com knowledge base. So in summary, we introduced the concept of virtual private networks and discussed the types of VPN tunnels and protocols supported on DrayTek routers, and then we looked at how to choose the right router for both the main office and for remote workers, which at the moment is attracting a lot of interest in the face of social distancing and other restrictions that businesses are currently having to deal with. At the moment, we're still going strong here at DrayTek Australia. We have lots of stock in our Sydney warehouse as well as up here in Queensland, and we've taken steps to make sure we can keep trading and shipping. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02 9838 8899. Don't forget to like and subscribe below and give the bell a click if you'd like a notification of new videos as they go up. Thanks and bye for now.